time to be excited about God. Amen?
Amen.
Because he's done what? He's forgiven us of all of our sins. He's empowered us with the Holy Spirit. That means you are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus who loves you today. Amen?
Yeah.
So whatever it is, get ready to shake it out, throw it out, box it up, send it. Don't send it to anybody. Just get rid of it. Amen? You ready to go? All right, let's go.
Wait.
So this is the decoration. I know if you're either new or didn't know what's going on, you're like, this is an interesting choice of church decor. But we have that starting tomorrow, so that's why this looks like it does. It's awesome though. We had a great team come out yesterday and do all the decorating, getting ready for our vacation Bible school this week. But let me go ahead and open up with prayer. Lord, we thank you for today, and we thank you for the opportunity we have to be in your house. Lord, we count it an honor, a joy, and a privilege to be here, joining together with our church family, uniting to worship you, Lord, to glorify your name. We welcome your Holy Spirit here with us this morning to guide, and to minister, to direct, and to be our teacher. And Lord, we desire that we'd be hearts open and prepared and ready to receive everything that you want to pour into us here today. And we thank you for all that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, church, let's stay on our feet. Let's let the neighborhood around here know that God is alive in this house.
Amen.
Because he And he's worthy today, right? He's worthy, Father, that we worship and we praise your name and we say, you're holy, Father. You're holy, you're holy. We love you. We bless your name. There's none like you. Just worship him today. Just worship him with your heart today. See?
together. The power of the Word of God. And I think it was George was saying earlier about how in the middle of our junk sometimes we need Jesus to hold it all together. You know that God's Word is actually holding everything together. Even those that don't even believe, don't know anything. They don't even know it or acknowledge it. The only reason that they're breathing, living, is because of the power of the Word of God. How much more for us who have revelation of the power of that Word, when you know that that's what it is. The song we're singing right now is actually called Revelation Song. I love that. When we get revelation of who God is, we have revelation of the power of His Word, the power of the name of Jesus. It changes our perspective in life. It doesn't mean that we don't deal with situations in life. It just means we look at it differently. Or we look at everything that comes our way and know, I've got the power to overcome this because it's not me. It's not limited by what I can do and what I can do to fix this. I have the name of Jesus available to me. And the name above every name. Everything has to bow at the name of Jesus. That's what's available to you. The power that holds an entire universe together just by existing, the Word of God existing. That power is available to me. There's nothing I have to fear. There's nothing I should be anxious about. I have that available to me. And I know sometimes we have a difficult time because we're human beings, so we don't operate in that perfectly. But you know, it's available to us. And if we'll just press through, get past all the human limitations that we have, the fear, the worry that come, when we have stuff that comes our way. But we have to push through those things. It isn't wrong that it comes up. It's part of who we are. But we have to remember what's also available to us. We don't have to be in fear and worry. I don't have to have anxiety about that decision that I have to make or that situation going on. I know I have the name of Jesus. I have the power that holds the universe together available to me. I'm going to pull upon that name. Amen? I want to ask for our prayer partners to come forward right now to be available. If you would like prayer for anything, we want to pray for you. We want to agree upon the Word of God over that situation in our life and see it come to pass. There's power when believers come together and agree on His Word. When we agree, we're saying, it's done. It's finished. We see it is done. We see that what Christ did at the cross has already solved this problem. We're in agreement on this. So I want to encourage you to allow someone to pray with you and see that Word come to pass for you.
To
to you, and we come to you and present our petitions to you, and we pray according to your word that you've given us. You've given us your word to reveal to us what your will is, so we can pray knowing your will in a situation. We've come into agreement on your will. Your word tells us in 1 John chapter 5, when we pray according to your will, that you hear us. And then it goes on and actually tells us, we know, Lord, that when we know you've heard us, it says that we can then know we have the things we've asked for. So we've prayed according to your will. All the promises of God are yes, and they are amen to those who believe. And so, Lord, we see those things come to pass. Even before we've seen it with the natural eye, we know that it's done in the spirit. And as we've come into agreement with it, we will see it come to pass in the natural. Whether it's immediate or whether it takes a moment for it to happen, Lord, we know it's already done. So we can already give you thanks for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Give Lord a hand. Why don't you just take a real quick moment, shake someone's hand, let them know that you're glad they're in church today. See, what's the next thing I need to do? We need to take a moment now and to welcome any first-time guests we have. If this is your first time here, I just want to say welcome. I'm not going to make you stand up or introduce yourself or do anything that might embarrass you. I just want you to feel warm and welcome here at Living Word. I want you, you might ask, what do you guys believe at this church? Well, we believe in the Bible, that it is the Word of God, that it is truth. It is the only real source of truth that we have, and therefore it's what we should build the foundation of our lives upon. We believe based on what his word shows us that we serve a God who is a good God all the time, who has nothing but good in store for his kids. Now, we certainly don't deny the bad things happen in life, or don't think anything like, well, if you got problems in life, maybe there's something wrong with you or anything like that. What we do know is this. Jesus said in John 10:10, he said, the enemy comes but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So if you have that going on in your life, that's where it's coming from, right? God's not into beating you up and taking all your stuff. Right, he's there to bless you. Jesus actually goes on to say in that verse that I've come that you have life more abundant. And so he wants us to have an abundant life, but how do we get to it? Well, we get to it by putting Christ at the center of our lives. We get to it by putting him at the center of our home and our family and our marriage and our health and our finances and our job. Whatever we'll put him at the center of, we'll experience a more abundant life. And we're on a journey and we're learning and we're growing together as a church in those things, and we invite you to be part of it with us. If you are new, we actually ask for everyone to fill a connection card out for us. If you got one of those when you came in, that's great. If you didn't get one, put your hand up to us. Just get one of those to you right now. If you're new, you can just give us as much information as you're comfortable giving us. The back side of that card is really the part that's more important to me. And you'll see there, really the most important thing to me on that card is the area for prayer requests. And the Pastor Tammy and I do pray over each of those every week. We have a prayer team that prays, an intercessory prayer team that prays all week over those prayer needs in our church. So know that you do have church family that lifts you up, prays for you continually. You can turn those cards in as you leave service today. The ushers will be at the back doors as you're leaving. You can drop them off with them on your way out. If you happen to miss one of them, you can leave that at the information counter as well. And then if you are new, I'd love to meet you after service and shake your hand and get to know you a little, answer whatever questions that you might have. At this time, I want to go ahead and dismiss our youth to their service. And now it is time to receive this morning's offering. Let's praise God and talk with God.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning.
Say good morning. All this vague about, but y'all gotta get excited. In Proverbs 11:24, it reads, there are those that, who generously scatter abroad and yet increase more, and those that withhold more than is fitting or what is justly due, but the result is only want. It's kind of talking about the seed. We're going to plant a garden. Say, we got a garden. It's been composted, turned over, tilled, and it's ready. It's all beautiful. So we got good soil. We got a nice water source. get the sun, because you live in Arizona, you're never going to be without it, right? What is missing? You got to scatter something, don't you? You got to let go of the seed. If you hold on to the seed, or if you're eating the seed, and never makes it to the soil, you're going to be always in a condition of want. That's what Proverbs is telling us here. But if you scatter lots of seeds out there, you're going to get those fresh green beans about this time of the year. They're coming up right now. Right? Let go of the seed. But this, we need the seed. But if we don't scatter it, it's never going to come back. You're going to stay in a condition of want. For every need you have today, there's a lack of seed sown previously. Ooh, ouch. Right? Think about that a second. If you sowed previously, you wouldn't be in want. So the seed will meet your need, but it's got to be scattered. And we got beautiful soil here in Living Word. Beautiful soil. We got missions. We got things all across the world, across the globe. We're helping churches. We're planting churches. We're changing people's lives. We have programs to build families. Pretty good soil. Let go of the seed. That's all I'm going to say to you. Let go of the seed. Put it in the soil. Those wants won't want to be anymore. Amen? Yeah. Let's pray for it. Father God, we do pray for the seed about to be sown in great soil. Father, we pray that it goes into the soil, that it does what it needs to do. It's blessed by God, taken by God, it multiplies, it changes families, it changes hearts and lives. It brings people into the kingdom of God, Father. But more importantly, Father, it returns to the sower. A thousandfold return, but to plant it. In Jesus' name we pray, blessing Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So I realized this is just so funny.